After 30 years of release, Windows 95 finally has a live CD variant. Hooray! Well, not really, but kind of. Hi everyone, I'm Everything Windows, and this is Windows 95 RAM Drive. Before we look at this unique edition of Windows 95, I have to disclose that I'm running the OS in 86-box with the following specifications. And now, let's check out the disk. When we boot up the CD, it prompts you to boot with standard drivers or modern drivers, assuming that you are gonna run this Windows 95 on a more modern PC, but not like 2010's modern PC, it's just like the 2000s modern PC. After that, it lets you know how much you do want to have for the RAM disk, which is basically a temporary storage medium inside of RAM, hence the RAM disk. In this case, I'm gonna choose 32 MB because my RAM is 64 MB, and it's also good to split it in half between RAM disk and the actual RAM. It then copies the necessary Windows files to the RAM disk. Think of it like how Linux Live CD works, but in Windows. After some minor steps, here we are on the desktop of Windows 95 RAM Drive, or maybe we should call it Windows 95 Live CD. I'll tell you the reason later in the video. Since I emulated the appropriate hardware for the era, I decided to install one of the drivers for it, a display adapter. The process of installing a driver is similar to how you would install a driver in the normal Windows 95 installation, which in this case, I'm installing an S3 display adapter. Oh yeah, one thing about this copy is that you can't restart it in the normal way, but instead, you must restart it in MS-DOS mode, since Windows 95 is still DOS-based. You can reboot it to DOS, exit from DOS, and you're back in Windows. Well, to be fair, the installing drivers part in this Windows is a little bit less snappy than what we usually encounter in a normal Linux distro. But hey, this is Windows 95 from 1995, so the procedure of how it works is maybe quite different. Now we are properly on the desktop. Here we are with 1024 by 768 pixels in 4:3 ratio, which is smaller right now when you have a 1080p laptop monitor. Gosh, I remember how terrible it looks in 1360 by 768. Okay, back to desktop. The look of it is like what a normal Windows 95 installation from the surface, except with the additional program shortcut on the desktop, which will come in handy later on. Opening the start menu, it still feels normal until you open the program options in there. Yes, it's basically empty with only startup folder that, well, leads to nothing. This is done to squeeze the OS as small as possible, like what modern Tiny 10 and all of its variants. Opening the Windows Explorer, you can see that the Windows installation is on drive W. Get it? W? Windows? And there's the CD, which is on drive X. I can remove the disk from the VM, and it still works. Because, as you see earlier, all Windows files are already copied to the RAM disk's drive W. Of course, this technology isn't new to the operating systems in general. Ubuntu or Linux gave birth to the term Live CD back in 1992, and the concept of offloading the operating system to RAM to make up for other programs and applications already exists way back in Windows 1.0 and Macintosh with the use of removable floppy disk drive, either single or dual. Correct me if I'm wrong. Back to the desktop, the program shortcut on the desktop actually leads to a directory on the disk's drive. Well, you have to insert it first, or keep it inside to view the files. That's why I refer to this more as a live CD than a RAM disk. The program's directory contains many applications designed to run on as many hardware as possible. These are IDA32, is the application to view advanced system information. BCM Diagnostics runs one or more diagnostics on your PC to determine its capability, like audio, CD-ROM, disk, graphics, memory, processor, and more. CPU-Z, as some of you already know, displays detailed information about the processor used in your PC. EwinView, yes, it's pronounced as EwinView, is used to display graphics. Total Commander acts as a dual view file explorer. WinRAR views, extracts, and archives RAR, ZIP, and other archive files. And lastly, XVI32 is the hex viewer included in this Windows 95 to modify files in hex format. These applications are already really useful when you want to diagnose or analyze your hardware or software when something goes terribly wrong. Although this one isn't as complete as Hiren's boot CD, this Windows copy already brings some basic diagnostic applications that you can try. But there's more. Under the Microsoft directory on the program's shortcut, there are still more applications you might want to try. Some of them are Password List Editor, System Policy Editor, and of course, Internet Explorer. Remember that the Start menu is empty? Well, it's all moved into this Microsoft folder, so you can still use basic applications to do your normal computing tasks like calculating, writing, painting, and more. Ever feel bored in this operating system? Well, fret not, because there are games that you can try! One of them is chess, which I am absolutely clocked in. Another game included in this is Ski Free. And can you believe it? Reversey! There are still many games that you can play while you're repairing your computer or something. This experimental Windows copy is done thanks to WinDestruct, the creator of the functional copy of Windows RG and Windows FU. Can't believe that person really made this one. Check out his archive.org for more information. Since this is basically a stripped down copy of Windows 95, you can still customize the appearance by right-clicking the desktop. You can customize the background, the screensaver, and the window theme. Control panel is also included, but I don't think it's much of a use in this copy, as it should be wiped after restart. Oh yeah, I forgot that there is the Ghost app in the programs folder. It requires you to use DOS to run this program. So, by restarting the OS into DOS mode, Ghost, which is actually Norton Ghost, then a semantic ghost, is an application for disks cloning and backup. So, if you ever want to clone your Windows installation, you can do it right here. While I was roaming around the OS, my intrusive thought led me to click the Windows Tour on the welcome screen, thinking that it wouldn't work. But rest assured, it works! For some reason! And it's not just like work like working, but it works! All topics of help are still available if you Boomer Pops wants to use the SOS. Although I don't know what this OS is used for your Boomer Pops aside from, I don't know, like roaming around Windows 95 like a clueless person. And just to remind you again, all of this runs inside of a RAM. You can see that the RAM disk is there, 32 MB with 26 MB used. You can customize the RAM disk size, as you see earlier, up to 256 MB, depending on your usage case. Although again, this technology isn't new to like operating system, but at least in Windows, this is quite uncommon. Oh yeah, one last thing. What happens if you do not restart in MS-DOS mode? Well, let's find out. Well, that doesn't sound climactic, doesn't it? It just restarts with all modifications wiped out. I guess you can try this concept out yourself and maybe repair a computer that's totally older than you. Gosh, can't believe that Windows 95 is 30 years old.